Hey guys, it's Gadget.
Well, Gadget, as in Gadget when she wears her goggles.
Because I can't be a cat anymore. Neither can my anime friends. And let me turn this off because it is cold in here, but it's my little heater back here. So, I don't know if any of you have Facebook with me or anything, but I woke up late today. Really late. I got up at like 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. Because I've been dealing with a lot of people who are having problems. I should say. Some are having friend problems, some are having boyfriend problems, some are having problems with their marriage. And then there are the friends who are calling me and crying because they've been unfriended because of the situation at hand here. Now, here's the thing with me. I don't do politics. I don't want to do politics. I don't vote. Never have, never will vote because the government has screwed me over too many times. And I'll give you a good example of how the government screwed me over with a lot of things when I tell you, all right? I said it on my other ones. I don't do politics. I do about fair chances and how people's actions cause a ripple effect and everything, okay? And I'm going to have my phone with me because there's something from the movie Beautiful Creatures that I need to also mention too, okay? And also to explain to you that I am an oddball when it comes to things, all right? I have no yes, no, no. I have no derivative this, derivative that. I am neutral when it comes to things. I also will not fault anybody for having an opinion. And I'll explain to you why people I let go and why I don't let go. Because people have this one notion about everyone that we're all the friggin' ass same and we're not. All right? Now, I don't want this going political. I don't want this going any which way. But I'm going to explain this to you guys right now. Get out a real history book. No Wikipedia, no electronics. Get out a real history book and see what all your friggin' ass presidents have done since the day before Washington. Because Washington was not the first president. There was somebody else. And that's in the history books that I studied. I don't remember his name. And I think he was black. Okay? But when I was taught history, that was in the 1980s, okay? I'm going to explain also that to you. I am a 70s baby, born in the 70s. Heck, I'm born in the bicentennial year when our country turned 200 years old. I have a quarter that says that, okay? I call them my birthday quarters, 1776 to 1976, okay? I am a 70s baby, an 80s child, because I was not a teenager in the 80s. I was a teenager in the 90s. So I'm a 90s kid, a 90s teenager, okay? You guys who claim you're 90s kids are 90s babies. Some of you weren't even around when I was in high school, okay? You are a millennial child. And then you now are a double-digit kid, whatever you want to call this thing. And I'm going to sneeze because when I sneeze, it means it's true. Or somebody's talking about you. See how different viewpoints, different see things about sneezing. Okay? I am also an oddball because I eat cottage cheese with a fork. Yes. I eat cottage cheese with a fork. So while I'm talking to you guys, I'm eating what I can for dinner because it's too late at night to cook anything. Okay? See? I'm eating it with a fork. Okay? I also came from a family that drank only Pepsi, and I was the Coke drinker. Okay? So we're getting there with this, right? I'm not the same as other people. So why do people presume I did something, or voted for something, or said something? And this is where you piss me off. All right? So while I put my cottage cheese over here, I know Shadow's hiding over there. Thank you. Clear my nose. I'm sneezing. And drink my Coke. I am also going to explain to people something. And it puzzles me very much so because why in the fucking world does anyone not do research on things? Why are people unfriending people who they've been friends with for over 20 years?
or good friends with or family members because of things? Why are people being mean, like bullies? Okay? I don't understand you guys. Yes, peaceful protests, peaceful whatever. Everyone's protested from the day we could walk. Protest is nothing new. Get a history book, a real one. Okay? That's what I'm trying to tell people. You're not the first people to do things. You're not going to be the last people to do things. But what upsets me is when you hurt somebody's feelings or hurt somebody because you fear what you don't know. And that's what a bully is. And that's what I've been trying to explain to everybody throughout these whole videos of what happened with me and Christopher, what happened with all my other exes, what happens in my life, what happened to me with everything. And when it hit home by people I thought that cared about me, and then it hit home with people that I barely knew and became friends with, calling me up crying because of this. How do I approach this without sounding like I'm a political person? And I can't, because this world is so stuck and plateaued. They're not seeing the big picture. They're not seeing when you throw that stone in the river, what ripples it creates, and what happens when the ripples end. The sound vibration from music, where it ends up. The spider's web, when you flick it, the vibrations go out and ends at some point, which is going to cause a ripple effect. Classic science people, okay, know this. Doctor Who people know this. Anime people know this, okay? This is why this one is going to be a little different tonight. Because I have to get this out. You could hate me all you want. Hey, haters, it's just people that don't know the good they have in them because the darkness surrounds them. And that's also what I'm going to talk about. And why I'm going to tie in anime and a lot of other things. Because people don't do their research or watch what they say. All right? Okay. Or see themselves as less of what they are. And that hurts me too. Because I see potential that people have. That's my gift I was given. All right? And that's sad that I get shunned for a gift I have, because I can point out what the outcome is of that ripple effect. And a good example right now I'm going to tell you is this. Today, there were people that were marching, and I'm going to call them people in the sense, because you're going to see why I'm calling them people. Because a congresswoman sent me an email and was getting frustrated with me because I was not attending the woman's march. She said, I have a ticket for you. I have everything. Come to New York City and all this stuff. Come down and march with us. Not my cup of tea. I get 4 days off. I have fibromyalgia, costochondritis. I have to take a bus everywhere and stuff. I'd like to get some sleep. I'm writing stories for a podcast. I'm working on things. Okay? I have too much time on my hands to deal with this. And you know why I say that? Because one, that congresswoman's whatever assistant or woman called, claiming they were from that office, asking me all these questions. And the questions were about birth control, women's rights, school. There was five main things, five main ones. Job and all the, like, you know what I mean? Just stuff, the five main ones, right? So the first question was, why aren't you attending? I said, because I have better things to do. But you're a woman. I said, repeat what you just said. I said, I have better things to do. And you said, because I'm a woman, that I have to drop my better things I'm doing because I'm a woman. Oh, no, sweetie, you misinterpreted. I said, no. You just said, because I'm a woman, I have to drop everything I'm doing that's going to further my career, or that's going to help me get better, or the rest I need for my... Oh, no. I'm sorry, sweetie, you misinterpreted me. Okay, that was one. The second thing was, do you know if you don't attend this, he's going to take away your birth control? I hate to tell you, sweetie, but I'm allergic to birth control. Yeah, there was dead air on the phone. What? Yeah, there's a chemical in some of them that actually can cause death
in me, and I'm allergic to that chemical. And there's also some that have steroids, and I'm allergic to steroids. Oh, so you can't? No, can't take birth control. Then what do you do? Oh, I have ways and everything. I found a natural way to prevent, and it's a natural birth control. It's two herbs that you can take over the counter and everything. Oh, we didn't know that. I said, yeah. So, strike two for you guys. Okay, so that was, I had to drop everything. That was about the medical and the all that stuff with the right. Then the next one was education. Do you know he's gonna take away your education rights and everything and stuff? And I said, well, I've already graduated and I had to pay out of pocket anyway. What? Yeah, I don't get scholarships. I don't get anything. No matter how many times people think I do and they presume I do, I don't. And she goes, what do you mean? You're a woman. I said, yeah, I don't get scholarships. But there's women's scholarships. No, I didn't qualify for them. Why? One, I'm not Spanish. Wait, you're not Spanish? I said, no. What did you think I was? Well, you don't put down what your race is or anything. I said, yeah, because I'm human race. You don't have a spot for human race. Do you want me to put Gallifreyan? Do you want me to put that all the races I found on my DNA test? You don't have enough spaces. Wait. What are you then? I'm Irish Italian. But your name's Felicia. I went, yeah. It means certain things to some people, like bitch and everything, but I didn't say that part to her. But Felicia's a Spanish name. Was like, no, it's not. It's a Roman Latin name that got branched out in different languages. It's said every which way. In Irish, it's Fiona and all the other stuff, right? But it's a Spanish name. We thought you were married. Did you look at my paperwork? I'm single. You're single? Oh, okay. They're like, okay. So that was strike three for them. Thank you. So the next thing was, let's see, first we did that, they did that, they did that. What was the next thing? Because it was all on, this was all on Thursday night, Friday, that this girl was doing this because of everything, right? Oh, see that. Then it was like, oh, so where are you working? We have free programs and everything and stuff. I said, I'm working, and I can't say where I'm working, guys, but I'm working here. I only work 18 hours because I didn't get 85 or better. What? Yeah, didn't you know state jobs want 95 or better? But wait, you're telling me you're not a city worker? No, I work for the state. Oh, you live in the Bronx, so how are you working for the state? I was like, okay, you're a congressman or a congress whatever, and you don't understand the difference? No, it's just that we don't understand. I said, because we're out of the city. We help the city. But we're deemed state. So she was like lost at that one, and even lost when I told her about everything else. It just kept going on like that, and she goes, I really can't do anything for you. This march is not for you. I said, yeah, pretty much. She hung up the phone on me. Okay. So that was the first time I ever heard about the march, nor cared about the march, you know? Then I come to find last night, I'm going on wish.com and I found the cutest. It looks like a page boy hat with the cat ears on it, right? For an anime series that I have been wanting so bad because the conventions charge like $25 to $50 for it. And this was deeply discounted. And I wanted it so bad. As soon as I was about to check the order out, make sure it was legit and everything. My friend sends me a post from the Daily Mail about pussy hats. And I'm like, pussy hats? What the hell is a pussy hat? Because I had seen something about it on The View, but no, like a little post snippet thing. No one showed the full article. And I ignored it. I was like, what the hell's going on, right? Because I couldn't even tell what they look like. These friggin' ass morons did not do their research and are using cat ear hats from anime, which is an icon, a. How do I put it? It's a how the word I'm looking for because my dyslexia kicks in on this. I know the word in my head. Thank you. I know the word in my head. I know it's iconic. It's representative of the anime world and certain cosplayers. That's what I'm trying to say. The way the goggles represent steampunk or Ghostbusters or things like that. The cat represents your anime world. A lot of girls go with cat, guy goes with cat, you know, right? I was wondering why my friend who did go to the march was trying to take my hat that I wear and looking for my cat ears every, you know, and she used to think, oh, it's cute, it's funny, you have little baby doll hats, you have baby kid hats, when are you going to grow up and everything, and then all of a sudden I couldn't understand why she wanted my hats, right? So now I can't wear my anime hat, my cat hat, see? I can't wear it because I might be associated with this. And you make it someone who is not in their right frame of mind, someone who hates what's going on, and someone who just has a grudge, see somebody with a hat like this from the back, right? At maybe a convention, an anime convention, or just on the street in Manhattan or anything, right? And may take action on them, allegedly. We don't know. Because so far everything's been peaceful, but we don't know. Then you'll have people saying, if you wear this, oh, you were associated with that? And when you try to say, no, this is my genre, this is this is what we wear when we go to conventions, this is a staple of what the anime world is and based on, mostly people wearing cat costumes or cosplay or cat ears or anything like that. Most of your Wiccans also like wearing the cat ears too, because it's a representation of magic and growth. Now, those people should just put vaginas on their heads. They would have made more sense if that's what you're complaining about him touching. But yet Miley Cyrus and some other actresses and everything grab their groins all the time. And you condone that, especially at their concerts and everything, where young children are impressionable there. But I would have thought someone would have done their research and found out that this has a staple in an anime society and a community. This has been a staple for many years. And now you've tainted that because now we're afraid. Some people, because I had phone calls from anime friends, that were afraid to go out and wear this. To go out as Luna. To go out as Artemis. To go out as Neko. To go out as anything that had cat ears related. I even have mechanical cat ears. Mechanical, see? Cat ears. That I was going to do for a skit for you guys, and I can't even wear them. Because now you guys may think I'm associated with this movement that a congressman I just proved to does not help me because I'm not what they want. Because the congresswoman did not understand that an Irish-Italian girl can have a first name like mine. Okay? She didn't do her research. She didn't look at my things because I had did a questionnaire because they asked me, thank you, about what do you want to change in our community? And I wanted to change the fact that I don't get anything. Okay? So that's why I didn't want this to be political, but at the same time, I just wanted you to see how people don't do their research on somebody. They just presume based on what they see in the name. Like when I go look for jobs, there's no HR person looking at my resume. It's an electronic computer-based program called ZipRecruiter that looks at my picture and all the information and my age. And you know why I'm getting turned down? Do I look like I'm 40 years old? 40? No. The computer says my age range I'm lying about. And they're doing age discrimination on me. Because according to that computer program, when I called up an HR department to pull my resume, who said, oops, we could have hired you. We needed somebody like you. Said that the computer said I was doing age fraud. And it was based on the fact that I look like I was 27, lying about my age to get the job. Otherwise, my qualifications were perfect. And I couldn't figure out. And then I called other places. I said, let me check something. Out of the 20 places I called just recently, 15 of them use ZipRecruiter. The other ones were looking for anyone of a different ethnicity or heritage, if you get my drift. And could speak a language. And I said, well, I have dyslexia. I can't learn a language. My dyslexia affects me learning languages. I'm good in math and sciences and problem-solving skills, everything else, you name it. Anything else, but I can't learn a language. I never could. So I researched the languages, and that's why I know a lot about languages and how everything works and why I love the Japanese language. And my second favorite is the Gaelic language now, because it used to be French. And then the third was now fourth is the Italian language. Okay? Chinese is a little like Cantonese and, you know, I can't remember the other one's name, but They're a little harder to learn, but Japanese uses pictures. That's why it's my favorite first, because it's easier to understand, but I can't speak it. I can't say a word of it because I don't say the pronunciations right, because I can't. I have a disability in that, but it doesn't stop me. Okay? People have called me stupid, dumb, mixed up brain and everything because of my dyslexia, because they don't know enough about it. Because they only know three, maybe four types, and there's over thousands of types of dyslexia. It affects different areas. I have all three. I have audio, kinesthetic, and visual impairment with language impairment. All right, so five. Wait, no, three, four. See? Okay. And there's some people who just have the audio and the kinesthetic. There's some people who have the visual and the kinesthetic. You know what I mean? There's so many, and just have visual, you know? There's so much out there people don't research on. Because they think it has to be handed to them. They don't have to work for it anymore. A bully fears what they don't know. A bully fears change. And that's what scares me. Are we turning into bullies because we fear change? Because now, as an anime person, I can't wear these. Heck, I might be scared to wear these because God forbid somebody does this next. Because they got the Star Wars generation too. Okay? Because you got those people out there that don't think before they leap. And that's what scares me because it comes to this now. I got a call all last night, not from, because one of my friends is actually going through something really hard right now. And she's hurting right now. And a friend betrayed her, just like someone betrayed me, except this person we know is not going to come back. Right? As I'm dealing with her, I'm getting tweets, text messages, things like that from people going, please don't unfriend me. Please don't unfriend me. I'm a good person. Please don't unfriend me. And I'm like, what the hell is going on? So I contacted them. I said, what's the matter? What's going on? I just got unfriended by my friend. I went to high school with this person. How could they unfriend me? And I said, what happened? And these are some people I've met at conventions who became my friends. These are some people that I've known for years through other things and stuff. It boiled down to this. People were unfriending people that they've known for years, all because of this. This march, this president, this whatever. And I'm sitting there going like, you know this person for this many years. This just happened. So this is like up here and this is down here. So, this has more merit as you being in someone's life than this that you've bled with them, sweat with them, you know, had seen their child born type of thing. But this has more merit than this, and you're going to get rid of somebody? 10 of my friends so far, since 3 o'clock in the morning yesterday, well, meaning this morning, have been calling me. Texting me and everything. And there's more. Even now. Another five, another three. Almost every hour, begging me not to unfriend them because they think a different way. And I'm sitting there going like, what has the world come to? And then I think of myself with Christopher. And I'm in that situation myself. Here I am, this American who fell in love with a British boy, because he's not a man. Who has friends that are for me and friends that are against me? The friends that are for me took the chance and got to know me and found they found a friend in me and praise me and are very good to me and have never left. Then you have the people who don't know anything about me, but only what Christopher says, and which are half truths because I've seen the paperwork on Facebook, thanks to a lawyer, and then started a campaign to witch hunt me. Call me the Wicked Witch of the East, bully me for 3 years, now four, you know, because they didn't know anything about me and only took his half truths, or he never told them much about me because they were scared of the unknown and did not want to get to know me. Then you have the middle that did get to know me, and some swayed to the side yes, and some swayed to the side no, because of another situation that went out of context and content. Because someone else told half truths, and that was Josh. So, where does that stand with me? The same way, like everything's going on now. You have to wait for the ones who are afraid to check out and do their research. You have to wait for that. And I did, because one of their mutual friends, Christopher, and his sister's mutual friend, did. And she watched all my videos and said, oh my God. And I have her, and I've mentioned her before on here, and I've even have her, what is it? Her Facebook letter to me. She was ready to hurt me because she didn't know anything about me. She was ready to side with Christopher and all this other stuff and everything. Then she saw the videos. She goes, oh my God, you two would have been perfect for each other if he didn't do what he did. I am so sorry that I did not choose to get to know you because I was listening to somebody I thought I knew. But thank God I took enough courage to not be one of the bullies that are bullying you. I'm paraphrasing what she said. She hopes that me and Christopher would ever get back together, but I was not to mention it. That's why I'm paraphrasing what she said. But at the same time, that means she's scared of being my friend, because by association, then that means Christopher and his sister would have to admit the truth of what's going on and probably lose her as a friend. But the thing is that that would be probably the best thing, to tell the truth. So all I kept hearing from these people that were calling me that wanted me to still be their friend was, you're not going to fault me because I think this way. You're a good person, right? I said, no, you're a good person. You know why you're a good person? Because you have an opinion like everybody else. It's sad that the person you were with or knew or family or cared about or friend felt that your opinion took them out of contact with you. Because they could not see for themselves yet what the bigger picture was. All they saw was the darkness and hate. And that's what I'm going to get into about darkness and light soon. Because there was a good movie on today too about darkness and light. Okay? I am never going to unfriend people unless you do harm to me, accuse me of something, or basically lie about me. And presume I do things because you think that's what people do when you don't know people. They said, I know, we watch when you watch live. We do that. We knew you wouldn't do that to us. I said, no, I'm not. And I said, do you want to know why I unfriended Christopher? Because that's the one thing they asked me. They said, we know because we saw you do it to somebody. I said, the reason why I unfriended Christopher was because I could not fight all the darkness alone. I could not do it alone. I asked for help and no one wanted to help me. So I had to give him up because not only because of things, but he had already given me up to the darkness that surrounded him, because he couldn't see the light anymore. And I had to pay the price for that all those years, because darkness reigned over him and it still does. I know where I'm going and I see where I'm going, maybe because of gifts I have and everything. That's why I very much like this movie, Beautiful Creatures. Because there's one line in particular, and I'm going to read it exactly because it's really a longer line, but this is just the premise of it. And I really wish I could find it on here because I would really love to play it for you guys and everything. But it's what Lena says to her mother. And it's a very good and very strong saying. There's a new world, Mama. It ain't all dark, and it ain't all light, and it ain't all ours. It's not only casters, it's not only mortals. It's everyone. Okay? Now, if you know Beautiful Creatures, you know the story has a very poignant religious as well as magical meaning to it, with very good points in it. We are not all dark. We are not all light. We have to claim ourselves, and we have to balance the dark with the light. We're not the only ones in it. We have to embrace both sides and see the big picture. That's basically what that is saying. People have light, people have dark. It's how you balance the two in your life that makes you you, that makes others see how you portray yourself in the world. If you're only going to be seeing darkness, then darkness surrounds you. The darkness will claim you. like a Death Eater, like anything. The darkness, you're calling to them. Too much light, you're going to burn up and die. You're going to burn up and just be a bunch of ash, flames. But if you can balance that light and that dark to the point where you are a neutral, you are a centered, you claim yourself. You claim yourself. And I said that to these people. Who are you? Do you know who you are? And they said, yes, yes, yes. I said, do you really know? Then I said, if they really are truly your friends, they will come back. They will come back and apologize for all the friendship that was up here. Sorry, this was all the friendship that was up here. And this little thing that happened just yesterday. That if this didn't happen, you still would have had a friend. Do you see what I mean? But then some people are also using this to get out of bad relationships because they couldn't get out before. They're making excuses that the person does this and likes this person or likes this or didn't like this because their opinions don't. And they, oh, we got to go. Bye. They're using it as excuses. Remember, I'm dealing with people that I was raised sheltered. I was raised in a family that saw no color, no hate, no nothing. Okay? No racism, no whatever this. Because I see people as they are. I see what your actions, your ripples, what you do and everything. The same thing like from the same movie. Ethan had asked, let me get her name and everything. Amma. Ethan had asked Amma, you go to church all the time. You believe in God, but also believe in this because she was a keeper. You know? If you read the books, if you watch the movie. You know what she said? And I have it right here. God created all things, didn't he? It's only man who goes and decides which ones are mistakes. I like that saying. Because do you want to be considered a mistake by man? Because if God created everything, or the God and Goddess like I believe, do you want to be deemed a mistake? Because we weren't supposed to judge each other. It was him or her or whatever you want to do or call it in your religion. The person you believe in is the judgment. You can believe in many things, have many opinions. But it's yourself you have to answer to. Claim yourself. And I feel bad for all those people that have been dropped from people's pages. Including people who have dropped me from their page because they had lost the light inside them. Because they wanted to be a follower and not a leader in their own life. You can still follow people, do things, share likes and dislikes. But when you lose the light and the darkness of being a leader, your balance, your yin and yang, what does that say about you? I lost a boyfriend, a best friend and a friend to the darkness. Because he let the darkness consume him. And let them make the decisions about me and him. And not let us make the decisions. And I had to let him go, and that hurts. That really does hurt. But what hurts more is the fact that I have now people begging me to keep them on my page or begging me not to disown them as friends, family, or anything because of an opinion that others have because they think they're going to just unfriend people because they don't think the same way. Even though their friendship was all the way up here for like years and years and years. They were like this. They were siblings, like all this stuff, all because of a little incident right here. How do you perceive that? How do you explain to somebody that they actually do have merit, that the person that you got to just let them be? You just have to let them find themselves again. And like I said, if they're your true friend, they really cared about you, loved you, they'll be back and they'll apologize. They will. Because this is only the first day of this. What's going to happen in the first week, the first month? Thank you. The first 6 months, the first year. Are those friends that ditched everybody on their pages and everything because of this viewpoint that have been friends this long and only this little going to come back? Are they going to try to resolve it and apologize? Will that friend that was dropped want to take you back? Because if you really were, like I said, their friend, you would have just taken in his opinion. Ha ha, okay, you don't have the same opinion, but like, okay, let's go eat, you know, type of thing. You'd rather just cut your ties. That means you weren't really a friend. Or like boyfriends and girlfriends or boyfriend and girlfriends. You You didn't want to be together. So that's how you did it. You caused a ripple effect. And speaking of also ripple effects, the news cut this part of the story, but I caught a glimpse of it because I had turned it on because they went live and everything. Not going to say what newscast it was because, you know what, I will give them that respect and everything. This young person, and I posted it on Facebook, the news people said, oh, what do you think of this march? And he says, well, I just lost some hours at work. And they go, what? Because no one was shopping because everyone went to the march and everything. This person, hours were cut because there was nobody shopping. So they didn't need the person anymore. And Saturdays are usually, for a retail person, a very big day. These are the days we always look forward to because this is where we make most of our money. And if you're living paycheck to paycheck, this march, this ripple effect from it, did have an outcome at the end of the ripple. It cost somebody a couple of hours of their job that they could have bought or paid bills, you know? Bought food for their kids because now their paycheck is docked. Hey, because there wasn't enough people selling products to put into the profits to make sure that these employees were paid. So you see what I mean? So, and then you have those people that were rioting. And what is that going to do? That means that you're going to have something on your police record that if you go look for a job that you are qualified up the wazoo for, and this HR, this boss goes, you broke a window. You caused vandalism. Why am I going to hire you? Oh, that was just because I was speaking my rights. Yes, I understand about speaking rights, but what happens here if you have an argument with your fellow coworker, or if you have an argument with me or anything? Are you going to take that chair and throw it at my head? Are you going to throw it at another coworker? Are you going to lash out at the coworkers because that's where you go straight to violence based on what the video of the news crew shows of you as well as your police report? I'm a good person, sir. Not based on your actions. I see you quickly have a very quick and fast temper. So I don't think you're a good fit for here. Because God forbid, and or anything else, however they say it now in the world, because you can't say God anymore and everything, God, you know. I, for fear of damages and fear for my employee safety, I cannot hire you. Have a nice day. Maybe you can find something else with somebody else where you can take out your aggressions on. But you're too aggressive for this place. Now the person getting hired can't really sue because it is now videotaped, filed with a clerk in a law office, and documented that you are this type of person. Because they do ask you if you have a police record. And you can't hide that anymore thanks to technology. Years ago, when I was growing up, there was no internet. The military only had it. And I had to explain that to a 20-year-old. Because she kept going, oh, you had the internet? No, I had black and white TV and rabbit ears. And that's another thing. Rabbit ears doesn't mean I was broke, people. Rabbit ears is a metal thing that's sitting behind me that has two little things you put tinfoil on when you had to get reception because there was no cable. You didn't have to pay for TV. It was free. Yeah, we had free TV. TV was free. Yeah, that's a concept, guys. TV was free. Let that sink in for a minute. For those of you that don't realize, we didn't have to pay to watch a movie on our computer. We didn't have to pay for cable or anything like that. We actually wrote letters. Yeah, granted, they took forever to get to places or anything and stuff. But we actually socialized. We actually did things. It's a different world. It really is a different world. So you had that situation today. I had to calm people down saying, I will not leave you as a friend. I would not leave you. Christopher knows why I left him. Because I couldn't fight the darkness alone. And that's sad because he is a good person. It's just the darkness took him. Swallowed him whole. And I was not turning into one of those, oh no, hell no. I already dealt with darkness, and I'm still dealing with it across the hole. But let me drink this. So now, to reiterate, can't wear my cat ears because I'll probably be associated with the fact of that and probably get hurt or injured, allegedly, because of someone who doesn't do their homework or research. Told you what the congresswoman said. If you go back, you can listen to it. And let's see. I told you just about this and the violence and about job things. Okay. Now, What else is going on today? Like I said, I slept in. So there was basically not much going on. Oh, and I can't write stories for the podcast because from watching and reviewing things and stuff that people have been writing about, it seems people are altering stories, allegedly. So I don't know what's a real story about today because there's a lot of movie stars like Peter Capaldi. There's also like the girl who plays Supergirl, all this stuff. There's so many things that are going on that everyone has gone to this thing today. Okay. But everything that I'm looking at right now, I don't know if it's a real story or not, or it's fabricated. You already had someone being investigated right now that I just saw the new thing on. I'm going to sneeze again. That means somebody's talking about me. I am just sitting here trying to be me. I have no say in anything whatsoever. I don't vote because this is where I'm now. I'm going into about how the government screwed me over. I am dyslexic. Have been since sixth grade back in the 80s. Actually, 1986. No, wait, I was diagnosed in... I got diagnosed in sixth grade, but they suspected in second grade. So early 80s and everything, right? There was no funding for me. They didn't know what it was or anything. So my parents had to pay out of pocket. And then when they figured out what it was, they were going to dumb me down so I can get funding because I was too intelligent. Yes, that's actually how it was put. Because my IQ is over 300. I should be in Mensa right now. But my mother didn't want me to have a big head like some people. So basically, I was mainstreamed with everybody else because she didn't want me to be arrogant, self-centered, and everything. Okay? Like some people. That's how she put it. But so I was mainstreamed. And it was fun when I got to high school because my freshman year, straight hundreds and everything. Because of all the hard work I had to do every night so that I would pass my classes, being up till 2, 3 in the morning, I never slept. Because I had to study that extra hour. Didn't have the internet to give me the answers. I had to carry around something called a netbook in grade school. And then a big-ass WB, or was it Word Processor, that had a handle. The thing weighed more than me. That's why I'm very strong in my arms. With a printer I had to carry that was bigger, okay? The battery was the size of my phone. That's the size of the battery was for these computers, okay? Lithium batteries. I had to do this all through high school as well. I had to have people with carbon paper. You know what that is? Okay? It's hard to describe because it actually is like mimeograph paper. And I know some of these words you have to look up, people. But it would mean that someone would write my like their notes and it would transpire them onto another piece of paper because of carbon. Carbon fibers, carbon ink, you know? So, with that, that's how I had to get through school. But the, like I said, the best part was I was in math class because they thought, oh, let's take her out of honors and try to mainstream her even more. So my sophomore and junior year, I was put into the lower classes. And that's when I maintained like straight even more. Like I kept maintaining the 100. They just messed me up in my English class and my language classes because, like I said, that's where the dyslexia hits me. My spelling and my pronunciation of language. So French class was not fun. Okay? We only had Spanish and French, and I took French. Okay? The only reason it saved me a little bit was because there was some Creole spoke in the family, so I knew a little bit of the French words. But I drove the teacher nuts. So they had to make me do projects so I could pass the class and learn the languages, like learn about them, study them, and I had to write a report about them. Okay? So, this was my schooling, but in math class, my teacher left me alone in a corner because I would sit there with headphones and play music because I'm a math genius. Yeah, guys. Math and sciences are my forte. He'd sit there and he'd go like, okay, class. And I'm sitting there with the headphones. I got my head down and he goes, wakes me up and goes, what's the answer? And I go, that. And he goes, go back to sleep. Or he goes, go back to listen to your music. Go do whatever. Right? He didn't know what to do with me. So he gave me other math problems to do. He was like, you could do quantum physics. You could do this. Yeah. One of my teachers, my other math teacher, when I was in sophomore year, was it? Yeah, sophomore year. Said I created new math because I showed her how you can get rid of three steps and still get the same answer. That they're unnecessary steps. And now those steps are gone. okay, in math today. But then you have this Common Core, and I'm looking at Common Core, and I'm like, you really want to fuck with people's minds. That's not even math anymore. We don't know what that is. That's alien language. But that's where I tell you guys, I'm unique. I am different. I don't fit the mold that people have created for me because they don't know me. And it's sad to see all this and everything. And yes, today too, you think I didn't stop about talking about Christopher? No. Because during those phone calls too, there were some hangups as well. So I know people are slowly stopping the bullying with me and at me. But at the same time, is it him calling, sighing in the phone like last time? Or is it somebody else trying to talk to me? All I know, people, is this. Like I said, people are being mean to people because of something that just happened. That they've known people their whole life and they're being mean to them. It amazes me on that fact. But it does reiterate a fact about what bullies can do and when people fear the unknown, how they can strike like a wild animal. You don't go up to a wild animal when you don't know what's going on. They can be scared and they're not wild, or they are wild and they can snap. You get that one person that does not like what's going on or is pro whatever and sees this from the back. That person who did not partake in this or feels that they want to go to an anime convention is now have to fear for their safety, allegedly. Okay? Because there are people out there that are not of their right minds and go with the masses and everything because they heard it wrong. And like I said, you could take this any way you want. But don't hate me for pointing out the fact that there's a repercussion to the ripple effect of what you do. What you say out there does have an effect on people. Everything I'm saying now, too, is causing a ripple effect because I may get that one person that may hate my guts. And I love reading hate mail. So that's why I'm like looking like, okay, when are you guys going to start sending the hate mail again? Okay? I love reading it out loud. Okay? Because I know who I am. I know what I do in life. And I know how to treat people because I do not want to be treated that way. Because, yeah, it's upsetting when people take you off Facebook. But then think again. There was no Facebook when I was growing up. There was all your little friends in the yard playing. I don't like you anymore. I'm going to go run home and hide. I don't like you anymore. That's fine and great. And then when they became adults, you know that thing that happened in grade school? I am so sorry about that. Would you like to be my friend since we both grown up and we understand each other? Now, you could hold a grudge. You could hold a grudge. I only say hold the grudge if that person either pushed you down a flight of stairs, smacked you in your face, cut you up so bad that you almost died. Stuff like that. Then you don't friend them anymore. No. But if it was a simple misunderstanding, an argument that could have been resolved with either time out, either discussing it, a phone call, walking away and breathing, could have been anything. But when you get the little like his friends, like anything else, that they don't know the whole story or the big picture or the outcome of when they throw that stone in the ripple in the water and that ripple effect, or the plucking the spider's web or plucking that guitar string or playing that violin, you know? There's outcomes to everything. It's when you finally reach the end of that outcome. I need something that shows a ripple effect or something to show you what happens when you do that. But like I said with the movie, it's not all dark and it's not all light. It's a new world, mama. It is. And people, it is a new world. A world where we're shaken up right now because people who were lying there dormant, you know, or the people who weren't taught enough or who don't ask questions or unfriend people that they've known for years, all because someone doesn't like or like something. I got presumed at work that I voted for somebody. I don't vote. I don't go to jury duty. Part of the jury duty is because I worked on a show that dealt with juries and everything, and my view is skewed because of that. Part of it is my dyslexia, because they're afraid that I will give the wrong interpretation. Part of it is many things, because if I don't work, I don't eat, I don't get paid. So it's basically a catch 22 for me. There, it's not illegal for me not to go to jury duty. I don't know where someone even said that. I'm like, no, it's not illegal. It's also my right not to vote, because now I'm getting to the big part about it, how the government screwed me over. Because ever since Obamacare came into effect, or the Universal Health Care Act, before that, my medical was based on my salary, and I only had to pay a little portion of everything, which is what originally sounds like Obamacare. Okay? But here's the thing. All of a sudden, they cut my benefits, saying that my salary was too high and I don't get medical insurance. Then all of a sudden, here comes Obamacare. And then I have to start paying, which everyone thought was like 20 bucks. Nope. That was just the initial starter's fee. And I say starter's fee because it's like a club. It's monthly, and you have to pray you can afford it the next month. Okay? Yeah, here's Obamacare. Join our subscription and everything. For just $20, you can get this part of the package. Oh, wait, you need glasses. Let's put $30. Oh, wait, you need dental. Let's put $50. Oh, wait, you went to surgery. Let's add another $100. Oh, wait, you want this package? Okay, so you want this package, and oh, $450 a month. We hope you can afford it. Oh, here, let's do this, right? And then you still have to pay deductibles, everything else. Okay. I said, what the fuck? So I did sliding scale at the hospital, and I take a hit every year on a penalty. And the penalty started at $100. Not bad, right? This next year, it went to $400. Not bad. All right. This year, it's $700 for not having insurance. But I still make out in the deal because I didn't go to the doctor this last year. I went to the clinic and did sliding scale and didn't have to pay anything. Okay? So if you divide 12 months into 700, you're looking at, let's see, 50, let's see, 5 is 5 is 60, right? So that's 10, and then 12 into 10, 0. Yeah, because of that, 0. Almost $51, maybe, if you round it up, a month. Yeah, for not going to the doctor, that's okay. Yeah, I can afford that. They just take it right out of my taxes. They take it out anyway. I never see that money anyway. Also, like scholarships too and everything. They have nothing for me. They're looking for something else. They told me I had to have a deadbeat husband or an illegitimate child for me to get TAP. I don't get food stamps. I make too much money according to them. But yet, before all this stuff changed over in the government, I could get food stamps for my salary because I only work 18 hours. Because, unlike people think there are no jobs out there. A lot of us went back to school so we could try to get jobs, but then all the people in the high power jobs got lost their jobs, and there's even more retail stores and everything else closing down because everybody's going to online is going to online. Thank you. So, I already see I'm at 53 minutes. So you see why I never got free education. I never got anything. Every time something came up, now the thing with you go to college for free, I still had to pay $5,000 and have over $30,000 in credit card debt because of the school. So 35,000, 35,000, 40,000, no, now 40,000, I forgot because of the interest. $40,000 in debt just to pay for school. And that's only on credit cards because that was the cheaper way. Because I had to buy books, I had to buy a new computer, I had to buy all this other stuff just so I could get through my classes. Okay? But what the biggest thing, like I said, was I can't wear now my cat ears. I can't wear these out. I can't show you those things because everyone's going to probably associate me with that march. I have friends that are crying because friends are unfriending them and begging me not to unfriend them. You have people that are not knowing the whole picture and being bullies because they're afraid of the unknown. You had a writer bully his son, you know? Opinions are okay. But when they start getting nasty and hateful and hurtful, and when you say you're going to do something to hurt others, it's not only physical, it's not only mental, it's also emotional. Because maybe that friend on Facebook really did care about you, and you just lied through your teeth about them. You used them for their connections, or you used them. Because they can't understand why, if you were friends for so long up here, and this one little incident. Does that make sense? Do what you want with this people. Hate me all you want and everything. But I just had to speak this out because what I'm seeing here is the fact that no one wants to do their research. No one wants to see what's going to happen to the outcome of this. Because I'm waiting to see when the ripples end after these stones. After that violin has been strummed. The guitar has been plucked. The vibration on the spider's web. When it finally stops, what's going to be the outcome? He's already in. That's one thing. Okay? But how are you going to affect others? How are you going to affect change? Yes, everything was peaceful and everything. But you already see the repercussions now of the stone being thrown. People are unfriending people that they've been friends for over so many years. People are running scared. People are, you know, you got everything. Everyone's blaming somebody else for something else. I got accused of being a voter for this. And I'm like, I don't vote. And I look at people like they keep seeing themselves as one thing that society keeps deeming them as. And I don't see that because I see the potential in people. I just see if you're going to say you're this, this, and this. No. That's what society's making you dark, making you doubt yourself. Look at yourself. Claim yourself. The world is not all dark. The world is not all light. Claim yourself. It's a different world and it's not all ours. It's not all casters and it's not all mortals. It's not all Death Eaters and it's not all Orders of the Phoenix. It's not Weeping Angels, it's not the TARDIS, it's not the Doctor. It's not only Torchwood. It's everything. And it's not all ours and it's not all theirs. It's everything. Claim yourself, see yourself. If you know you're a good person, that person still wants to leave you, that's them. It's not you. I left Christopher. Because he left me. The dark claimed him. And I was light trying to balance him out. I have friends that their friends, the darkness, claimed them. Because of a small incident. And I said, don't worry. If they really are your friends, they're going to come back. Once all this blows over. You're safe with me as long as you don't betray me. And that's what Christopher did, betrayed me. And that's what all these other people's friends did. They betrayed them by not trusting themselves as well as around them that this is just opinions. And that everyone is still the same even before this happened. People, do your homework, do your research. Don't hurt somebody because others think that you have to follow that template or anything. You can have a difference of opinion. You can care about things. You can hate things. But don't hurt someone you love because others are telling you you have to leave that person because they don't agree with what you say. If that were true with my life, I would have ditched everybody a long time ago. Or people would have ditched me a long time ago. But I have friends that have not ditched me. They still understand that I have an opinion of my own, but I am still a good person. I just feel bad for those that are crying right now because they don't know why they've been unfriended. Why someone hates them all of a sudden. Why their boyfriend left them. Why their best friend left them. Why their boyfriend left them. Why their girlfriend left them. You know? Look at yourself. It's not only light. It's not only dark. It's a different world. And claim yourself. Balance the two. I know I do. Can you? I'll talk to you guys soon.